And when we return, we'll learn more about Houdini's rise to the top and meet Dean Gunnarson, a death-defying daredevil who will rise to new heights for us. Stay with us and see Mrs. Pendragon's trunk. It was Houdini's ability to promote himself that led us to ask escape artist and Houdini devotee, Dean Gunnarson, to help us give a little promotion of our own. As Houdini had done exactly 72 years and 1 month before, we sent Canadian escape artist Dean Gunnarson to the corner of 8th and Hill Street in downtown Los Angeles, one block from where we stand right now. That's where the old Los Angeles Express Tribune newspaper building was. And from the accompanying photos, you can see what Houdini did there. Let me read. While the greatest street throng in the history of Los Angeles gazed on in awe, Houdini, the Orpheum's wizard of escape, defied death and freed himself from a regulation police straitjacket while suspended in the air, head downward, in front of the Express Tribune building shortly after noon today. So that's what we asked Dean Gunnarson to do. Let's take a look at the scene of 8th and Hill as it was Thursday morning when Dean became our Houdini in getting the press to take notice of our show. Here's Dean arriving at about 9 o'clock in the morning, Thursday, and being greeted by the crowd that had begun to gather an hour before he got there. We had hoped for a good turnout, but even we were surprised by the crowd and the great press turnout that greeted me. After talking with the press for a moment, Dean began to strip fresh. Here you see him stripping fresh. He's being put into leg shackles by his friend and guru, two magicians, the world over, the amazing Randi. Needless to say, the accuracy of the placement of these leg shackles and all of the support equipment that Dean is using is critical to his survival. There is a barefoot being shackled. Hands tying him in. And now Dean is being put in the straitjacket with the help of a Los Angeles City policeman who hasn't had too much experience. And this is no ordinary straitjacket. Unlike normal jackets, this one was designed with additional cinches in the back and an extra long pair of sleeves and a crotch strap that is virtually impossible to remove. And then does Dean plan to escape from this formidable piece of apparel? Well, folks, I think we're just about to see him. His feet are now secured in a special brace. Dean is being lifted into position with the help of a motorized crane. There he is, being lifted by several men and a motorized crane that rests at the top of this Los Angeles landmark. And now he starts to go up, slowly moving higher and higher, but very slowly, above the L.A. streets, till he's almost 70 feet above the track. Dangling by a cable, head down. He's waiting for a signal to begin. Yes, he's got it, and he's off. While Dean is not trying to best Houdini's record for escaping today, the danger that faces all men in this position is evident. While Dean struggles to escape from the straitjacket, the blood is rushing to his head, and after an unspecified time, but certainly under 5 minutes, will make him lose consciousness. Don't think that Dean's not aware of that as he struggles to free himself from his bonds. He's making some headway now. Headway. He's just about gotten his arms free. He's almost, he's got them free, but he's not out of danger yet. Getting those cinches in the back undone is no small matter. And time is ticking away. And it looks like he is just about. Yes, he is.
is almost... Look at that. He's free. He is free.